time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Wassell family. Ed, Polly, Joe, Louise, and Jack. Ready for action. And the Keller family. Shannon, Bill, Christine, Maureen, and Camille. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Five. Count them now. 5 days to 0 hour. May 8th, we're going to do a 1 hour primetime special of Family Feud. It's never been done before. They've ever taken a show out of daytime and put it in primetime. That's Monday, May 8th. Cast of Soap, Three's Company, Eight Is Enough, and Love Boat. We're all going to be here. Now, once you call all your friends up and tell them, it's 8 o'clock here on the West Coast and the East Coast, and as they say for the rest of the country, consult your local listings. Don't they always say that? Consult your local listing. But call all your friends, will you? Because this is the number one daytime television show. Yeah. I want us, listen. I want our special to be the roots of all specials. I want the biggest audience in America. Call all your friends, okay? Here's the champ, the Wassell! Eduardo!
Oh, there nice to see you.
A little hops out there, huh?
Yeah.
Well, Ed and his little band of merry followers have $10,528.
This is my first wife, Polly.
Right.
My second son, Joe, second of four. My only daughter, Louise.
Right.
And her husband, Jack Kojak Kuczynski.
Right.
From Nanticoke, Pennsylvania. All five.
Right. You're on vacation still.
Yes.
You and your wife?
My wife and I and the rest.
4 months
here.
You've been on vacation.
Well, we waited a long time for it.
That's right. You said this is the first vacation you've ever had?
No. I said the first vacation I had, I waited to be until I was 44 years old.
Well, you told me you were 45.
Seven.
Where did you go?
Well, we sort of explored the whole of Southern California.
You think you might move here?
I think so.
Yeah.
We love it.
I hope so.
Yeah? What do you mean, I hope so? Just tell him you're going to move. What's he going to do? He's not going to leave you. No.
We got to come out here.
Sure. How are you?
I'm fine, Richard.
There's a young man who, if you're not feeling well, it's good to know he's here and not in your operating room. No, he's where? Port where?
Port Hueneme.
Spell that.
H-U-E-N-E-M-E.
Hey, for Port Hueneme.
Good job. That's not what I asked. I asked you to spell that.
C-H-A-T.
Good. Now I know our money's going in the right place.
Hello, Richard.
You have a child?
Yes.
Well, you too.
16-month-old Jan Michael. Can I blow him a kiss?
Sure. And this is the bad news, Jan. This is Dad, the little rascal. Here's a family going to challenge you called the Kellers. Hello, Shannon. How are you?
I'm so nervous.
Don't be nervous, darling. Really? Nothing to be nervous about. Who have you got here?
My husband, Bill. My sister Christine.
Yeah.
My sister Maureen.
Wow.
And my sister Camille.
Delighted to have you here.
Thank you.
Please
very much.
Don't be nervous.
I won't be.
It's just
I'm
a
better.
Game show.
I'm better now.
Yeah, yeah, we'll have a good time. Where do you live?
San Dimas.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where is that?
Near West Covina.
Oh, that's one of my favorites.
I know.
Sure, I love that. What do you do, Bill?
Richard, I'm a real estate appraiser for Wells Fargo Bank.
We attract them like flies. Everywhere we go. How long have you been in there?
Three and a half years.
If that's tough, I'll withdraw it. I don't want to. You're so sweet. What do you do?
I'm a designer.
Of what, clothes?
Yes.
Jewelry, clothes?
Clothes.
Clothes. Did you design that?
No, not this particular one, no.
Well, if you become a winner, will you wear something you've designed?
Certainly.
Okay. Did you design this?
No.
Well, then give me a kiss. What do you do?
I work for At Once Incorporated.
For what, darling?
At Once Incorporated.
At Once?
Uh-huh.
What is it, guard dog? What is that one?
A clothing manufacturer.
Oh, are they?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know that. How are you, Camille?
Fine, thank
you're
you.
You're so cute. What do you do?
I'm a student at Cal Poly Pomona.
You're as pretty.
Thank you.
Boy, isn't she lovely?
Beautiful.
Play Camille laugh. Greta Garbo, I believe. We're delighted to have you. Come on, let's play the Feud. Here There we go. 100 people surveyed. Top four answers are on the board. You have to try and find the most popular answer. Here's the question. Name something teenagers talk about.
Yeah. Their boyfriend or girlfriend.
Give me one.
Oh. Boyfriend.
Boyfriend. Yeah. Their boyfriend. Not there. Let me finish it. Name something teenagers talk about when they get together.
Sex.
Been on vacation too long, eh? Sex!
What are you going to do, Richard?
Name something teenagers talk about when they get together, Polly.
Dating.
Dating.
Good answer. Good answer. Very good.
Talk about dating.
Hey!
Very good. $72.
Joe. I'm going to say athletics.
Good answer.
Sports.
Very good
sports.
Answer.
Yeah. I know a teenager who happens to be a very good sport. Let's take a look and see. Sports! Oh, not bad. That's your first strike. Get three of those, they get a chance to steal. Louise, name something teenagers talk about when they get together.
Popular music.
Good answer. Yeah.
Good. Yeah.
Popular music!
Yay!
That's right. $83 and one answer left. That's right. That's what all my sons talk about. Jack.
I'm hoping they talk about school.
It's a little late
good
for you
answer.
To try.
I'm only good at fast money.
Yeah. A little late for you to try and change your image here and suddenly become a moral leader. Anyway, let's take a look and see. Do they talk about school? What can I tell you, Jack?
I love it.
Well, this obviously will be my last show, and I thank you. Jack will be taking over. I always know when to leave, just at the right moment. We have to leave right now.
Mom, I'm thirsty.
Some punch, Pinocchio? I've mixed some tropical punch flavored Kool-Aid, but this is his favorite.
Kool-Aid has vitamin C, costs less, and I bet he likes the taste better.
Better than the leading can punch?
We'll see. Mom, can I have more Kool-Aid?
Vitamin C, costs less, and he does like the taste better.
Pinocchio wouldn't lie.
Tropical punch flavor Kool-Aid brand soft drink mix. The taste the can drink can't match.
For always knowing that we love Jell-O pudding, here's to Mom. Yeah. And for always letting us lick the spoon after she mixes it, here's to Mom. And for not getting mad at us because we wore Dad's bowling shoes into the bathtub, here's to Mom.
Kids love Jell-O brand pudding. And since it's probably on your shelf, why not make some tonight?
Here's to you, Mom.
Wassell's 87 and nothing here for the Kellers, but they got Bill. Come on. Come on, Polly. Whatever hand. You know.
I'm left-handed.
Are you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's all right with me. Okay?
Right.
100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board to this question. Name a famous conqueror. Yes, sir.
Attila the Hun.
Attila the Hun. Wonderful guy at a party, isn't he? Attila! Oh, is he going to be cross?
William the Conqueror.
William the Conqueror! William! Yay! You control it. What are you going to do?
We're going to play.
William the Conqueror, I know about him. Go.
Alexander the Great.
Uh-huh.
Good answer.
That's a good answer.
Alexander the Great! Number two. 29 in the bank.
I don't know.
Famous conqueror.
Cortez.
Is it?
I don't think
well,
so.
I don't
I doubt it.
Yes. What did he conquer?
Mexico.
Not much.
No, I think he gave up to you, Juana.
History wasn't my.
Is that your strong suit?
No.
But let's see if he's there, shall
okay.
we? Okay. All right.
Sounds good.
Look at that great explorer and conqueror, Cortez! No, that's right, he was an explorer. I don't think
yeah,
he conquered,
did I knew he was an explorer.
Yeah, he just came in and gave Big Macs out. He never caused any trouble. That's your first strike. Jack.
Well, I don't know how far they go back on this survey, but I'll say Julius Caesar.
That's the one.
Well, that's a good one. Yeah. He makes a very nice salad, by the way. Julius Caesar!
Hey!
There you go. Eight people said it. $37, number one answer, number five answer, the only ones not revealed at the moment, Eduardo.
I'll say Napoleon Bonaparte.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a goodie.
I hope.
Napoleon!
All right!
28 people said it, it's the number one answer. $65 there, one strike, Polly.
Well, I'm going to say it, he's not going to be very popular, but it was Hitler.
Okay.
Good answer, Polly. That's a good answer.
No, they don't have to be applauded to be there.
No,
nope.
No.
All right. If you see Schickelgruber up there, alias Adolf Hitler. Well, it's good. They got 159. Right now, wherever you are, Adolf, and it's probably Argentina, remember, we gave you a plug. We'll be back right after this.
Put Delta in, take washers out, forget about those washers you used to worry about. Once you learn, Delta's name,
Delta,
you won't have to worry about washers again. Delta faucets, the name you can trust.
For worry-free faucets, ask your plumber for us.
Delta and Del-X faucets, no washers, no washer worries.
Oh, Joe, you're missing your lettuce.
I got lettuce.
But you're missing it.
I'll use that absorbent paper towel.
You should use heavy paper, Scott towels. They're heavy in the hand, heavy on the job.
Care to compare?
You're on. See how Scott towels heavy paper drinks up this spill?
Look how much more of that spill Scott towels absorbed. They really made it right when they made it heavy.
Scott towels, the heavier we make it, the better it works.
Kraft Real Mayonnaise starts from real whole eggs. And you get whole eggs in every jar of Kraft Real Mayonnaise. Real whole eggs. And extra golden egg yolks. To make it creamy, smooth, rich, real Kraft. You've got to break some eggs to get real mayonnaise. And at Kraft, we do.
Doctors recommend aspirin twice as often as any other pain reliever. You hear lots of claims for pain relievers about strength and speed and gentleness, but you should know this. Doctors recommend aspirin twice as often as any other pain reliever. That's just one reason people choose Bayer again and again. Bayer aspirin has relieved more pain than any medication in history.
Well, our champs, the Wassells, have a great big lead, $159, and Keller has nothing. You got a job of designing new uniforms for, say, for the Navy. What would you do to sprighten that up a little? Tell me, just an idea.
I think probably add a little lace or something on the collar.
A little lace,
a little touch.
Well, no, there are little things you could do.
Yeah,
here.
Certainly.
What about single-breasted, wouldn't that?
That's
just
always
open your
nice.
Jacket
always
a second.
Acceptable.
Yeah, we got time. Yeah. Let's see if it works.
You want me to model?
No, just now. Just make it single. Let's see if it...
Bermuda shorts.
No, there'll be no Bermuda shorts in our designing. Single-breasted, maybe, just down to one button here?
Mm-hmm. I think so.
Yeah, a little... Do these... Oh, no buttons. See, now buttons would be good. Here.
Certainly.
Who designs the stuff for the Navy?
I have no idea.
Well, we're going to get
not
that
Christian
person
DiOro.
Out of the job. You are. Gonna, because you've got great ideas. Little lace. I like that. Thank you for modeling. And that concludes our show, ladies and gentlemen. No, the dollar values are double. And, darling, you've got to get into this,
you
okay? You've got to get, you know, if you win it, you get all the money. 100 people surveyed, top four answers on the board, a long question, so listen. Name something that both you and rich people have, but yours is much cheaper than the rich person's. Yeah.
An automobile.
Joe says an automobile. Number one.
Let's find out what they're going to do. We're playing.
Yes? We'll play. All right, go back there. I'm going to walk you back.
Oh, thank you.
What? Because I asked you to stay. There. No, don't leave. They're going to play. I just want to be near the ladies. Yeah. Boy, oh boy, $138. Well done, Jose.
Thank you.
Not just another pretty face. Hi.
Hi, Richard.
Cortez called me while I was away?
I hope not.
Name something that both you and rich people have, but yours is much cheaper than the rich person.
A home.
I'm sorry to hear that.
Good answer.
Good answer, but why don't you give her a better home?
See the home. Homes she has.
Yes.
Homes?
Right. Well, he's in real estate, you know, so we have a few.
Oh, elementary. Home!
All right, good answer.
I got to talk to our producer. I thought a house was not a home.
It could be. It's a matter of semantics.
Easy for you to say. Name something that both you and rich people have, but yours is much cheaper than the rich person's yet.
Clothing.
Yeah.
You used to be a teacher, by the way, didn't you?
You bet.
No, I wouldn't bet on it. In fact, of all the things I'd bet on, it would not be that. No, but anyway, you say clothing.
Yep.
Jack's looking for clothing! One answer left. Now, man,
it's getting tough.
No way. Here. Look at you, people over here came to challenge. They've got no money. You've got no strikes on you. One answer left.
Ready? Ready?
He's an architect.
Ready?
I've got the plans here. We'll have a pointy house in a big room. You draw your own stuff up?
Well, some of it.
Who does the other?
Well, I have some draftsmen that work for me.
Okay.
It's all right?
It's all right with me, pal. I don't want a house, so why would it bother me? Name something that both you and rich people have, but yours is much cheaper than the rich person's.
I'd say food and beverages.
You would?
Yeah.
Well, bet you said it.
Okay, we'll take that answer.
Jack, will you take a little advice? Shut up. You're looking for the dreaded food and beverages, and if it's there, you got it all. Clean sweep, shut up. You'll play once again for $5,000. If not, it's your first strike. F and B, food and beverage. First strike, that's all.
How about a small rowboat versus a yacht?
Very nice.
Good answer. All right.
The old rowboat versus the yacht. I try to get both in there. All right, now suddenly, got two strikes on you. Joe,
something
that both you and a rich person have, but yours is much cheaper than the rich person's.
I'm going to name something that I don't have any of, and that's jewelry.
Jewelry.
I'm going to buy that one. Yeah.
That's a good, secure feeling. Jack's going to buy that. He also bought Ed's answer and Molly's. Jewelry's up there. You got it all. Be a shutout. You're playing for the big money. If not, your third strike, and Keller's, you'll get a chance to steal. Jewelry! Oh, they're Keller's, aren't they? They're Keller's. Well, if I remember... They played every game, didn't they?
Yes, they did.
So you were over here plotting and never got a chance.
Disgusting. What kind of...
Rotters. No money there, but nice prizes for all of you. Okay.
Thank you for
your
nice
time. Will you watch our special?
Oh, sure.
We love it. Thank you, Don.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice day. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Who's going to play? Let's go. deal, Jack. Oh, yes. Well, as Jack says, I'll buy that. We will watch this.
When I give my kids candy, I like to know exactly what's in it. So I give them Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Reese's is real milk chocolate and delicious peanut butter. And in the summertime, I keep Reese's in the refrigerator. Those two great tastes taste great chilled.
Want to know what I like about Reese's?
Me too.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, Peanut Butter Cups.
Poor dear, stuck in the bathroom.
Not you, your Kleenex tissues. Look it, you don't spend all day in the bathroom, why should they? Kleenex has styles to go where you go. On your dressing table, handy Kleenex boutique tissues. In the family room, there's big and beautiful Kleenex family size. While the elegant foil box brightens any corner and keeps softness at hand. What brand gives you softness in so many styles? Only you, darlings. That's why Kleenex is the only real choice.
My gray hair looked awful. So when he called me his old lady, It wasn't funny.
I meant it affectionately.
I'm too young to look old. That's why I use Loving Care. It's not like most hair colorings. It's gentler because it has no peroxide. I just wash away my gray and wash in my own natural color. Me gray, no way.
I still call her my old lady.
Loving Care Color Lotion, only from Clairol.
Because you're too young to look old.
His sink's clogged.
Use Crystal Drano.
Easy, love. I know Crystal Drano's great. It busts the really tough clogs.
Suppose I tell you, you may never get another clog.
How on earth?
Use Crystal Drano once a week. Only 7 cents a spoonful.
Blimey, won't you dirt me metal pipes?
No.
Oh, don't pop your blooming cork, love. I'll use Drano once a week in all me drains.
You may never get another clog.
I gotta tell you, by the way, that this family, Wassell's, first time ever on our show. 3 complete clean sweeps. You got it all the way. So now let's do it again and get $5,000 here, okay?
Yeah.
Now, Jack is upstage here, folks. I'll ask you 5 questions. Give me 5 answers in 15 seconds. Try and think of the most popular answer. You've done it twice. Do it again, okay?
Okay.
You and young Jack get 200 points. You got another $5,000. 15 seconds, please. Time warp. Name something a mother does after getting the kids off to school in the morning.
Goes back to bed.
A food everybody can make.
Jell-O.
Something that's good for teeth.
Brushing them.
Something people grow fields of.
Corn.
A small but dangerous animal.
Skunk.
Turn around. He said, name something a mother does after getting the kids off to school in the morning. And you said, goes back to bed. Our survey said, 40. A food everybody can make. You said, Jell-O. Our survey said, 0. 2 people would have to say that. They didn't make our survey. Something that's good for teeth. You said, brushing. Brushing with Jell-O. Our survey said, 24, you got 38. Something people grow fields of. You said corn. Our survey said 46, you got 84. Small but dangerous animal. Boy, how I hate these when they come towards you. You said the dangerous skunk. Our survey said 5, you got 89. 3 of the boys. And now here's Jack. Come on, champ. You need 111. I'll ask the same questions I asked Louise. Cannot be for greater answers if you do. You hear this? I'll say try again. You give me another answer, champ. Okay?
You bet.
All right. Remind everyone, please, the answers Louise gave us. Give me 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something a mother does after getting the kids off to school in the morning.
Has coffee.
A food everybody can make.
Breakfast.
Something that's good for teeth.
Dental floss.
Something people grow fields of.
Corn.
Try again.
Wheat.
A small but dangerous animal.
Snake.
Turn around. said name something mother does after getting the kids off to school in the morning. You said? Drinks coffee, our survey said. 41. Coffee was the number one answer. You need 70 points. Food everybody can make. You said? Breakfast food. Our survey said? Eggs. Everybody can make eggs. I lay them here regularly. Something that's good. 40. You said? Dental floss, our survey said? 12. Brushing was number one. You're 58 points away from another 5,000. Something people grow fields of. You said? Wheat, our survey said? 16.
42.
Corn was number one. Okay, now you need 42 points for another $5,000. You always play it very close like this. A small but dangerous animal. You said? Snake, I'll tell you right now, it was number one. Is it enough? You need 42 for $5,000 more. Our survey said?
That's okay.
185, $5 for every point. You got a total of? 925, and we got to go. There you go.
Guess what?
We're inviting next door
for sandwiches!
But I'm making sandwiches.
A sandwich is a sandwich.
But a manwich is more like a meal.
What's a manwich?
Sloppy Joe's with Hunt's manwich sauce.
Manwich is thick sauce with tomatoes, onions, peppers. Makes my ground beef more of a hot, hearty meal.
Delicious.
Well?
You're right. A sandwich is a sandwich.
But a manwich is a meal.
In just 30 minutes, this Kenmore microwave can cook a 5-pound roast medium rare.
You're kidding.
Sure it can.
Kenmore can.
And now you can save $70 on this Kenmore microwave with touch control, variable power, and temperature probe. It's on sale for only $399.95. Happy Mother's Day.
Oh, George.
Aren't you ready for a microwave? Make it a Kenmore. Solid as Sears.
Love you. See you here on The Family Feud.
Some departing contestants receive Smooth and Silky by Remington, the electric razor for women that shaves as well as a blade. The Remington Smooth and Silky. And slip your face into something comfortable. Face Quencher by Chapstick. Moisturizing makeup, blusher, and powder. And from Munsing Wear, the classic knit shirt. Incredibly comfortable mercerized cotton and the famous penguin on the pocket. Munsing Wear, the people who bring quality to life. And put your hair on a high-protein diet with Menin's Protein 21 shampoo, hairspray, and conditioners. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Monday, your favorite television stars will be feuding on a special nighttime version of Family Feud. Eight is Enough versus The Love Boat, and Three's Company takes on Soap. Richard Dawson hosts the fun Monday on ABC.
Guess what?